pop up a half a dozen, 6,000 in initial claims. So he moved from an unrevised 223,000 to 229,000. Continuing claims moved from 1.758 up just a bit to 1.776. All right, on the price side for February, up 6/10. 6/10 on import prices. That's twice what we were looking for. And we gained 6/10 exactly last look from -5 to +1. We'll have to talk a little energy there because when you strip out petroleum, moves to +1/10. And you only gained 1/10 on our last look from -7/10 to -6/10. All right, year over year, down 1.3, sequentially falling down 1.6. Smaller negative than anticipated. Things come in, things go out. Export prices also up a half a dozen basis points. Big number. And if you look at year over year, up 3/10. So these prices are all a smidge warmer than expected. But yet, even as equities seem to be soaring, we seem to see a much more squishy environment in treasuries and sovereigns as a whole. Becky?
Rick, stick around. We're going to dig a little deeper into the data. Steve is here, too, and has been checking some stuff out. Steve, what do you see?
So it's a little hard. Rick is right. The numbers are hotter than expected, but it's a little hard to get too excited when the year-over-year non-petroleum import prices are down 0.5%. Petroleum prices down 8%. A lot of this number moves up and down with oil, and with America being such a huge producer and now exporter, some of that matters for American prices as well. I am interested in the jobless claims, though. It's a little hard to get the trend. If you look at it, you know, it looks like a ball kind of bouncing at the end here. But in general, the drift has been up, and there's been a lot of stuff to pollute the data, Becky, including the shutdown, other things going on. But it looks like there's this upward drift. I don't know when we're out of the zone where all the things that have happened, even just the year-end changeover from the Christmas hiring and then the Christmas firing. I don't know when we're out of that zone. But in general, when I look at a trend line, I see a lot of ups and downs, but I see a general trend up that's worth watching that might suggest a little bit of weakening in the overall jobless payroll numbers.
So what does that tell you?
It tells me to watch it carefully. It tells me that we know the economy is slowing. We just don't know how slow. And my expectation is that it doesn't slow all that much to, you know, below 2%. I'm hoping for a 2.5% year this year. Obviously, the administration's dialed in 3. The Fed's dialed in 2.3. You would expect jobs numbers to slow from where they've been, Becky. Remember, we were up breakneck at 300,000 plus. Nobody thought those were sustainable. Even the 200,000 plus was very, very strong. If we can settle down into this 125, 150 area, I think that would be a big success for the economy going forward in terms of stability to payroll numbers.